says boss. Whatever I may be CEO of a company, I may be manager of a company, or I could be anything. Every now and then, pause, reflect. Pause, reflect, then move on. So now you know where we are, do a course correction, change it. To do that, to get that self-awareness, I'm coming back to meditation. That's where meditation helps. The reason is, when I am calm, I'm more creative. Let's say you had a fight with somebody. Oh, you don't do that. But let's say you had an argument with somebody. And your madam or sir will give you an assignment. The next half an hour, talk about this subject. Will you be able to do that? Because your mind is not settled. Correct? We are not. We are not ready to do that. So all creativity comes when we are calm or pause or pause. Do you agree? So what we are trying to do through your college, while we have all your required skills, your discipline related activities, they are trying to give you the personal aspect of it. They want to prepare you as the brightest and more balanced MBA grads. When we go out, not every day my supervisor will say, hey, good job, Girish. No. Or not every time I give a task, my subordinate will listen and do it. Not possible. Correct? So I need to have those techniques and skills where I can manage the team, where I can lead the team. To do that, I need to be self-aware. I need to know what are my strengths, what are my weaknesses, so that I use my strengths for my advantage. I work with people, use their strengths for their advantage, give the feedback to them, improve their areas of improvement. Correct? So, to summarize, I would say that to design a personality, we need to pause. We need to pause because there are thousands of books on personality development. By then, by reading them, I will have changed myself. They are there to help me. But it has to be my authentic personality. What I want in core of my heart. Then, put some actionable goals. Once you know what you want to become, put some goals. Okay, if I want to become a manager in Citibank, or if I want to be recruited by Hindustan Labour, what is the attitude or aptitude they look for? Okay, fine, I don't have risk communication, or I am not very proficient in writing skills, whatever it could be. Make your own list. Then divide them into short-term, and some of them will be doing forever. So I can do an iterative process. You work upon those areas where you can see the results quickly. What happens? Once I get the result, I will be more confident. Correct? Oh yes, I have improved now. If you have a stage fear, you ask sir to give you assignment. Do it. Sounding board, identify somebody, rehearse with them. Talk to them. Am I okay? My body language is okay? Whatever it is, right? Then, next one, next one. So keep that chart ever, never ever have a list which is completed. Because perfection is endless. So, does it make sense? Friends? Okay. Now I will take some questions. Because when we know what to do, so let's have more from, let me hear from you guys. And then we'll try to answer some of the questions if you have. Never ever lose your aspiration. Don't hesitate, however big or small the question is. Because you are trying to design your own personality. You are concerned about yourself, right?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
A successful person can be a great personality.
Is only a successful person can be great?
Great personality.
What do you think? Others, anybody would like to answer? What's your name? Preeti is as a question, which is a genuine question. Anybody here would like to answer? Do you think only successful people, I don't know, successful is money, or is fame, whatever, according to her, if they can be good personality only, then can be good personality? I don't want to take a name, but a large, bigger value. There is an answer. Right? There are many people who cannot sustain the success if the core is missing. That is where the personality comes in. The core, what you talk about it, values, humanness, want to be lovable, good, all ethics, all what we discussed should be center of your personality. Look at it, right? I was telling you, somebody in your own school, your teacher, your neighbor, your family friend, they may not be more recognized in the market. You see want in them, there is also a kind of personality. Right? Yeah, so not necessarily. It can be one of the topics that article touches is an integrated inside and outside to be integrated. That's what the article is also talking. When you become a personality, great personality, or when you aspire for it, your inside and outside should be same. Otherwise, it's just great personality. You can't maintain it, right? So that is another exercise which they said that keep your inside and outside almost as harmonious as possible. Okay, any questions? Sorry, yeah.
So how to control the external factors when we are improving our personality?
Okay, good question. How to control external factors? If we knew, we would not have let our rupee fall to 71 rupees. I'm listening. Okay? So, Stephen Covey, have anybody read? Okay, I'm just telling you, buy a book today. 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. One of the habits, what he says, you know, in many of things, because there's a circle of influence. Right? I do not have control over others. What you have control is on myself. So that I can adapt and change. So in one of the habits he says, try to be understanding than to be understood. Something like that. That means don't expect people to understand you. You try to put an effort to understand other person. We always think that why they are behaving like this. But have I put an effort to understand them? We always want you to be understood, right? Same thing he says, one of the again habits he says, begin with end in the mind. When we are talking about personality, what you want to become. Keep that end goal because we are trying to otherwise get lost. So if I am clear about my goal, I will try to go as close as possible. So external factors, there is no magic wand, right? We agree. Only thing the way I can respond is if I can prepare myself. Handle that. I can only have a circle of influence, I can only have control of myself, that will, I will decide how do I respond to the situation. So it is my preparedness which will help me to respond it better. Because I can't keep on changing, I can change one person or one situation, but tomorrow another situation. Right? So then I start looking at fault at others, and they are like this, market is like this, stock market is down, this government is not good, but I do have a circle of influence which I can influence myself, and then I handle it differently. So I need to prepare to handle external circumstances better. Anybody else? Any question on personality related things? Or anything you have still not clear? How do I define where do I go from here?
Changing our personality, we will lose our originality.
Anybody is asking you to change your originality?
No. Some factors will influence us.
See, authentic leadership is core of myself. Keep that core. For some, it is values. For some, it is kindness. For some, it is love. Whatever it is. That is core. we don't have to change to be successful. We don't have to. Okay. Only thing I need to be polished is how do I handle different situation without losing my own identity. That is all about preparation. There is no magic. We need to prepare and we need to keep on preparing. The reason is the market is very dynamic. When you go out, it might be different. If you're going in the finance, the way the finance industry works is different. If you're in the marketing, the way marketing is working is different. So we have to adapt. Without losing our own identity, I need to have a self-awareness where I need to change, work on the short term, long term. So that is possible. Without losing my own identity, I can still excel. Okay. Yes. You have any question? Indra, you have any fundamental question? Yes. Okay. Yeah.
So can we change the personality means now or else we choose? Because personality will be brought from the childhood.
Okay, I want some of your friends to answer this. Can anybody answer that question? The question is, can we change our personality? Because it depends on our upbringing.
Yes, sir, we can change our personality. Like example, I will give of Narendra Modi. When he was born, he didn't know that he would be a prime minister in the future. So when at the age of 18, of course, I heard him, that when he thought of changing the India, so that time he changed his personality and that time he came into the new ideas.
Okay. So anybody else wants to add to that? Can we change our personality and how? She gave an example of one of our leaders. Anybody here? Can we change?
If you don't look at me also, I'll ask questions.
I have gone through your age, don't worry. Yeah, question is, can we change our personality? Because my upbringing is different, the way I'm brought up is different. At this stage, can I change my personality? Yes, why and how? Yeah, we can. That's really very good. Wonderful. How do you think we can do that? Yeah, what do you think? By adapting. Very good. Wonderful. Do you all agree? Yes. How do we adapt? Now, what do you need to adapt? Yes, go ahead. Skills, excellent. Then what else we need? Model, we need our role model. Good, okay, fine. Technology, do you think that we need technology also? Somebody says no. Why do you think so?
Not always.
Not always, but sometimes you need. That's fine. Anybody else? So you got your answer? See. Again, fundamentals. Fundamental is, we all have innate personality and if we aspire to become something, like what Nagaraj was telling in his first session, we want to set some goal for it, believe me, most of the leaders are the ones who have developed the traits, developed the characters of leadership. Not everybody, I'm sure, Narendra Modi would not have been such an orator from the childhood. I just give an example because we took it. Or Abdul Kalam. Right? Do you agree? Steve Jobs. You name any of them. All big leaders, if you look at their biography, it's always good to read some of their biographies. Always. Because it will give an idea what they were when they were in the making. By then, they are already finished products. Now it doesn't matter. But how did they reach there is what their biography will tell you. What went through me. Yes, as your good name?
Aishwarya.
As Aishwarya says, it is possible to recreate or design our own personality provided we are self-aware, provided we are self-aware. know our strengths and weaknesses, provided we know where we want to go, then all other things I can build upon it. I can take help. College is one example for you to take help. There are various teachers from various subjects. They will be an inspiration to all of us. Right? Okay, good. Any other question? Last one question. Okay. I have a question. Since now we know, correct? Let's be genuine. Because you know, otherwise Girish will come and go. Professor Patil will retire. Somebody will be, that's quite natural, right? One day. Let's be realistic to ourselves. We will also pass, go and do something. I think this is my thinking. We always need to spend time for ourselves. We need to spend time, some time for ourselves. Just pause. You know, this is an age where we are full of energy, full of enthusiasm, no restriction. Like if I give a chance, I will change the college timing. If given a change, I'll change the dress setup of the college. If given a change, choice, I can change everything. That's the energy what we are, right? Yeah. So it is a time also I can change myself. Do you all agree? So one sincere request, while we are going through these steps of programs, we talk about goal, we're talking about personality, then we talk about team building, time management, all that. Please make a list. Your own list. What do you want to go behind? Don't get lost just because I'm in Hubli, or I'm in Harvard, or I'm in Gulbarga. Don't worry. The life is beautiful. It gives equal opportunity to everyone. That Vijay Sankeshwar is an example for that. 1800 crore, what is the VRL turnover? You should have numbers in hand. What is the VRL turnover? 1800 crores. I hope so. If they have grown in the last 2 weeks, it's different. So from rags to riches. So that means Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, who were? Did they study in Stanford, Harvard? Right? Each one of us have equal opportunity. Just that we need to take, as my teacher used to say, take interest, capital comes on its own. It will give you capital. The capital could be your skill today, the capital could be your attitude tomorrow, it could be any of them. So take interest. So make your own list. Please make your own goals. Divide them, what you want to achieve today, which are immediate ones. I need to do them to face interview. Those are the immediate ones. I can't wait for them after 5 years. I need to improve my communication. I need to improve my body language. I need to have these attitudes or these aptitudes. Those are immediate ones, right? Make the list of them. Go crazy behind them. I'm telling you, be crazy about them. Go achieve for yourself. You don't have to dance outside, but you have to be crazy inside. That you will do that, right? Make your own goals and use ecosystem. See, most successful people were never individual performers. And you guys are going to be managers, you guys are going to be working in our corporations. You cannot be independent performers. You have to work with people around you, above you and below you, and people in your peer group. Right? So we need to have an ability to network, take people with their skills, identify their strengths, and give them the work which they can excel in. Right? They can only do it for others, then I can do it for myself. If I can do a SWOT for myself, I can try to help people with their SWOT. Right? Okay. So with this I would like to end. Please make your own diary. I think your private diary, keep it in your bedroom, close, in your below your pillow. Every day open it up in the night, just review. This is my aspiration. Where am I? Did I lose one day without spending time for my self-improvement? Tomorrow morning is a wonderful opportunity again. So when you get up in the morning, go with an idea that I can make a difference to myself. Keep this habit. You know, when we are successful, I hope all of us will become, we don't need to know we are successful. People around us will know it. That's a beauty. One famous personality told, and we like to conclude with this sentence about personality. He says, what personality to person is like a fragrance to a flower. Wherever we go, we create a warmth around us. Wherever we go, the motivation is like that. Wherever we go, there is a positivity around us. Imagine a flower is a plastic flower. If it doesn't have a fragrance, natural flower, it is okay, it is there, like any of us are there. So create a fragrance for yourself. Each one of you, us, each one of us, have that uniqueness in us. Go behind it. Go behind our heart's call. That sky's the limit. You know, one of the school my grandfather studied in Hyderabad in 1930s. In the school they have written, as you get into the school, what man has done, man can do. So each one of us can do what other successful people have done. Okay, wishing you all the best, and thanks for your patient hearing. Let me know how the session was there through Ajit or somebody. We can do something else. But make your own assignment. Make your own case study. Don't forget that. Imagine, you know what Usain Bolt or any one of the successful people, what do they do? Before they are on the field, they go through that in their mind. Usain Bolt runs mentally in his mind 100 meters marathon sprint. In the mind, who's that? Phelps, the Australian swimmer. He will run through in his mind whole one lap circle of the 200 meters swimming. He will imagine what kind of, I might get water splashed on my glass might not work, whatever, right? How do I don't want them to become the roadblocks for my success. So you mentally prepare. So that's why I walked you through what you want to become. So now you prepare mentally. If this is what I want to be, imagine, then you prepare for yourself. Okay? And believe me, meditation is one of the areas, just not because I'm here and you can do that, we'll need to meditate, but it will give me a character to voice. For sure. If you ask me to be 100% sure, if you meditate, we will become self-aware. The biggest problem is that I don't know what I am. I'm running behind something. And I'll not be able to give 100% because I don't know what is close to my heart. How will I expect me to give my life for that cause? Not possible. So, with that, let's have a great personality from this classroom. Maybe after 20 years, I will have an opportunity to be one of your devotees. Thank you. We have 15 minutes time. Can we meditate? Is it okay? Few steps. Then I will stop commands. we'll all continue meditation. When it is over, I will say that's all. Before you open your eyes, observe yourself. Observe how's your body. Observe how's your mind. How are you feeling? Get a little bit of handle over your own condition and slowly open your eyes. Okay? Please close your eyes. Sit relaxed. Breathe easy. Breathe in. Breathe out. Let go. Next 20 minutes, don't worry about what's happening in the world also. Now slowly, bring your attention towards your feet. Feel your feet, your toes. Think that healing energy from Mother Earth is entering your body through your feet. As it goes up, it is relaxing each and every part of your body. Your feet, your toes, your ankle are now completely relaxed. Energy moves on. Now you feel that your calf muscles and your knees are getting relaxed. Energy moves up, relaxing your thigh muscles, your legs. Breathe easy. Now gently take your attention towards your stomach area. Energy moves up there. Feel all your stomach muscles being relaxed. So also all your chest muscles are getting relaxed. Now gently take your attention towards your back. Feel your lower back and your upper back. Feel all your back muscles getting relaxed. Gently take your attention towards your shoulders. All the stress that is there in your shoulders is melting away. Your shoulders are now being relaxed. Now gently take your attention towards your arms. Your biceps are relaxed. Your elbows are relaxed. your wrist, palm, fingers, all the way up to your fingertips. Your both hands are now completely relaxed. Gently take your attention towards your neck area. Now feel all the stiffness from your neck is released. All your neck muscles are now relaxed. Now gently take your attention towards your face. Your earlobes are relaxed. Your jaws are loosened and relaxed. Be gentle with your eyes. Your eyes are soft and gently closed. All your facial muscles are now relaxed. Your attention to the top of your head. From top of your head to the toes, your entire body is relaxed. Your mind is also relaxed. Gently bring your attention towards your heart. Have an idea that your heart is already filled with divine light. No need to worry if you see the light or if you don't see the light. Let your attention be there. If your mind wanders outside, without putting any pressure on your mind, slowly bring it back onto your heart. Continue meditation.
before you open your eyes, just observe yourself. Observe how is your body now. Observe how is your mind now. Take your time. Gently open your eyes. Just be with yourself. Don't rush into things. Thank you, friends. I'd like to see you again sometime. Keep in touch. Don't forget to create your own case study. When I was doing my MBA, my professor, Dr. Mark Cooper, from Coventry, he always used to talk about the beauty of MBA students in about case studies. No, you don't look at how did Coke launch their zero, Coke Zero or whatever campaign, or how did Coke get into African market, or how did Royal Navy become a cult brand. These are the nice studies. So make your own case study about yourself. Let's design our own personalities. Wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I wish Chetan sir to give me a tag of notes to his.
Thank you.
Time of your chosen